Good morning, children. This is lecture 2 of chapter hydrochloric acid. In lecture 1, we have discussed about hydrogen chloride gas. In this lecture, we will discuss about hydrochloric acid, its laboratory preparation, physical and chemical properties, test for chlorides and hydrochloric acid, and its uses. When hydrogen chloride gas dissolves in water, it forms hydrochloric acid. You all know that HCl is a covalent compound, but it gets ionized into H plus and Cl minus when it dissolved in water. You all know that it is a covalent compound, but it is a polar covalent compound. Okay, so it is getting ionized into H plus and Cl minus when dissolved in water. This is the reaction. HCl plus H2O, it will form H3O plus ion and Cl minus. Because the hydrogen which is forming from HCl, it is reacting with H2O and forming H3O plus. Okay. Trihydrogen chloride gas and liquefied hydrogen chloride does not provide H plus ion. Please note that dry hydrogen chloride gas and liquefied hydrogen chloride does not provide H plus ion. This means one needs a polar solvent. The polar solvent is H2O for ionization of HCl. Okay. Laboratory preparation of hydrochloric acid. The first part for the laboratory preparation of hydrochloric acid starts with the preparation of hydrogen chloride gas that already we have discussed in a lecture 1. Okay. Now, what is happening? Once the gas is produced, it is passed through water until no further gas is absorbed. Theoretically, one can reach 36% of hydrogen chloride by mass. Now, what is the setup that we are doing, setup used for the preparation of hydrochloric acid in the laboratory? This is the figure. Here you can see that an inverted funnel which is connected to the HCl hydrogen chloride gas supply. Okay. And the funnel is inverted and it is placed in a beaker such that it just touches the water taken in the trough. So this is a trough. In the trough the water is taken, and this is the inverted funnel. One part of the funnel, the delivery tube of the funnel, is connected to the hydrogen chloride gas supply, and the funnel is placed in such a way that it is just touching the surface of the water which is taken in the trough. Hydrogen chloride is highly soluble in water. So what is happening? As hydrogen chloride gas is instantly dissolved in water, water rises up in the funnel through the back suction. From the trough, the water rises up in the funnel and hydrogen chloride gas will get dissolved. This causes an air gap between the funnel and the water level. And what is happening? Water that enters the funnel drops down again because there is a gap produced in between the funnel and the water level, and that is why the water that enters the funnel that again drops down. establishing the contact. And in this way, the HCl, hydrogen chloride gas, is getting dissolved in the water, and this process continues till the beaker water gets saturated with hydrogen chloride gas. I think you have understood why funnel setup is necessary. Why not the supply line is directly connected to the beaker? See here, the funnel setup prevents or minimize back suction of water. If the supply line is directly connected to the beaker, water may enter the reaction flask and cause accident. So it is very necessary to set up the apparatus with a funnel. It also provides a large surface area for the absorption of HCl gas. This is a very important point. These two are the very important points. And the question is coming from here. Why it is necessary to set up the apparatus with a funnel? Water containing dissolved HCl gas is diluted, which may be concentrated through distillation. Again, I am just reading. Water containing dissolved HCl gas is diluted, which may be concentrated through distillation. A maximum concentration of 22.2% HCl by weight may be achieved that boils at 110 degrees centigrade. No further concentration may be achieved. Okay, so HCl forms a constant boiling mixture. This is known as azeotropic mixture solution at 110 degrees centigrade. What is that? What is that azeotropic mixture, constant boiling mixture? Constant boiling mixture is a mixture of a solution, miscible liquids, homogeneous solution. If we'll boil it at its boiling, at a certain composition, the boiling point of the distillate that we are getting after distillation, the boiling point of the distillate and the boiling point of the solution that we are distillating, both will boil at the same temperature. Both these two will have the same composition, the solution and the distillate. Both will have the same composition at a particular temperature, that will boil at a particular temperature. That is known as azeotropic solution or azeotropic mixture. That is also known as constant boiling mixture. So HCl forms a constant boiling mixture at 110 degrees centigrade. At 110 degrees centigrade, the solution and the distillate that we will get, those two will boil at the same temperature. At this temperature, there is no change in composition on boiling. Am I clear? Physical properties of HCl. Color, this is colorless. Smell, pungent choking smell. Taste, sour, it is acidic. Effect on skin, concentrated acid is corrosive and causes blisters on skin. Solubility, readily soluble in water in all proportions. Boiling point, 110 degrees centigrade, it is a volatile acid. Chemical properties of HCl. Nature, aqueous solution is strongly acidic and shows all the properties of acids. Action on indicator. You know that moist litmus paper is an indicator, methyl orange is an indicator, and phenolphthalein is an indicator. Now, HCl, hydrochloric acid, changes moist blue litmus to red. The moist is word is very important because you have to moist the litmus paper, otherwise hydronium ion will not form. HCl will break, it will form H plus and Cl minus, and it will react with H2O present in that. It will form H3O plus ion, and that H2O plus ion is responsible for the acidic property. It is showing the acidic property. So it is very important to use a moist litmus paper. It will change a blue litmus paper to red. It should be moist one. It is changing methyl orange to pink, and phenolphthalein will remain colorless with HCl. Next one, action on metals. Hydrochloric acid reacts with metals above hydrogen in the reactivity series. Okay, the metals which are present above hydrogen in the reactivity series, HCl forming metallic chlorides, and it is evolving hydrogen gas. Just see here, calcium plus HCl, because hydrogen can be replaced by calcium, because calcium is above in the above than hydrogen in the reactivity series. So it is forming metallic chloride, that is CaCl2, and hydrogen gas is coming out. Similarly, Zn plus 2HCl, it is forming ZnCl2 plus H2. You have to remember that, children, the metals which are present above hydrogen in the reactivity series, HCl react with those metals, because the metals can replace hydrogen from HCl, forming chloride of that metal, and hydrogen gas will be liberated. Next property you see, action on oxide and hydroxides. It reacts with oxides and hydroxides, these two are the bases, to form naturally when acid reacts with oxide or hydroxide, which are bases, they will form salt and water. Okay, this is a neutralization reaction, so you all know. So these are the examples. MgO, that is metallic oxide, when react with HCl, it is forming MgCl2 plus H2O. This is a salt and this is water. Similarly, Fe2O3, when it is reacting with HCl, this is a typical reaction. Please remember the number, that is 6. It's a very big number. Fe2O3 plus 6 HCl, it is giving you 2 FeCl3 plus 3 H2O. That means it is a salt and water is forming. Similarly, NaOH, when react with HCl, NaCl plus H2O, salt and water. So these are all neutralization reactions. Am I clear to you? CuOH2, copper hydroxide, it's a base. When it is reacting with HCl, it is forming CuCl2 plus H2O. Okay. Next is coming with salts of weaker acid. If it is reacting with the salts of weaker acid, that means suppose salt of weaker acid means suppose weaker acid is H2CO3, is a weak acid. Now suppose sodium is reacting with this. Then what is the salt forming? Na2CO3. Okay. Na2CO3 is forming. That is the salt of weaker acid. This is a salt of weaker acid. Now when this is reacting with HCl, suppose this Na2CO3 is reacting with HCl. What it is forming? It is forming a salt, water, and CO2. Okay, that means when it is reacting with carbonates or hydrogen carbonates, it will decompose. It decomposes salt of weaker acid. Weaker acid means carbonate and bicarbonate. It will give you metal chloride, water, and carbon dioxide gas will be liberated. Please remember, children, when HCl react with carbonate or bicarbonate, it will produce the salt, chloride salt, water will be produced and carbon dioxide gas will be produced. Okay, so these are the reaction. Please go through the reactions, write and practice. CaHCO3 2 calcium bicarbonate. When HCl is react with calcium bicarbonate, it is forming CaCl2, that is a chloride salt, water and carbon dioxide gas is coming out. So you have to remember in this way, when carbonate and hydrogen carbonate react with HCl, it will give you salt, chloride salt, of course, because HCl, Cl is there, so it will form a chloride salt, it will give water, and then along with that CO2 gas will come out. Okay children, now see here children, similar type of reaction. When HCl is reacting with sulfite salt or bisulfite salt, sulfite, ITE, sulfite salt, that is Na2SO3, NaHSO3, when it is reacting with SO3 or HSO3 salt, that is sulfite or bisulfite salt, it is giving you a chloride salt, that is NaCl is producing, water will be produced and it will give you SO2. Okay, NaHSO3 plus HCl, it is giving you NaCl, that is a chloride salt, water and SO2 will be produced. Next, when it is reacting with, when HCl is reacting with metallic sulfide IDE, Na2S, FeS, when it is reacting with sulfide salt, it is giving you another salt, that is metal chloride salt, and H2S will be produced, hydrogen sulfide gas will be produced. So you have to remember in this way, we got three. When HCl reacting with carbonate or bicarbonate salt, we are getting chloride salt, water and CO2 will be produced. When HCl is reacting with sulfite or bisulfite salt, then it is giving you chloride salt, water will be produced and SO2, sulfur dioxide gas will be produced. And when HCl is reacting with sulfide salt, then it will give you another chloride salt and hydrogen sulfide gas will be produced. You have to remember in this way. Okay. Note, just see here. Dilute hydrochloric acid reacts with thiosulfate salt. This is Na2S2O3. This is sodium thiosulfate. When HCl react with thiosulfate salt, then it is producing the chloride salt, H2O, SO2, and sulfur will be precipitated, that is known as yellow sulfur. Yellow sulfur. See children, the difference between sulfide salt with HCl and thiosulfate salt with HCl, see the same products are coming out, chloride salt, H2O, SO2. Here also it is chloride salt, H2O and SO2. Only difference is that in case of thiosulfate, it is giving you an extra yellow sulfur, is precipitated. Children, you have to remember, these are very important reactions. Okay. Now, reaction distinguishes thiosulfate and sulfite, as sulfur is not precipitated when sulfides are reacted with HCl. These are very important reactions, very important distinguish between these two. These are coming in the exam. Children, please be careful about it. Practice all the reactions by writing only. Okay. These precipitation reactions, these are very important children. Please see to it properly. Dilute HCl does not normally react with nitrates. But however, lead nitrate and mercury 1 nitrate reacts with HCl to give white precipitate of lead chloride, and mercury 1 chloride. Okay, so these are little exceptional reactions, so you have to learn it. PbNO3 whole 2 plus HCl, it is giving you PbCl2 white precipitate, and HNO3 is produced. And similarly, mercury 1 nitrate, when it is reacting with HCl, it is giving you Hg2Cl2, and HNO3 will be produced. Now, another thing, the precipitate of lead chloride, this precipitate, the precipitate of lead chloride dissolves on heating. Okay. Silver nitrate solution reacts with hydrochloric acid, and it gives a thick curdy precipitate of silver chloride. This is the test for HCl also. Silver nitrate is giving curdy white precipitate of silver chloride when it is reacting with HCl. The white precipitate, this is very important part, this is a tail part of the reaction. The white precipitate is insoluble in nitric acid, but soluble in ammonium hydroxide solution. So this is very important. This is a test of HCl. Okay, test of the chloride ion actually. It is the test of the chloride ion. In the laboratory, we are doing this test. These are the practical chemistry question. Test for chloride ion, we are doing the test like that. When HCl is reacting with AgNO3, then it is giving the white precipitate of AgCl. That precipitate is insoluble in nitric acid, but it is soluble in ammonium hydroxide solution. You have to write the full thing. Okay. Now, what it is forming? It is soluble in ammonium hydroxide solution to form a complex salt, which is known as diamine silver 1 chloride. This is the reaction for this. Okay. AgCl plus 2NH4OH, it is giving you AgNH3 whole 2 plus and Cl minus. This is diamine silver 1 chloride, the name of this salt. Plus H2O is forming. When dilute nitric acid, now it is dilute nitric acid, is added to the clear solution again of diamine silver 1 chloride, a white precipitate of silver chloride is formed. So again, with this, in this, if you'll add nitric acid, then it will give you white precipitate of silver chloride. When exposed to light, silver 1 chloride blackens since it decomposes into chlorine and metallic silver, which is liberated as fine black powder. AgCl, Ag2Ag plus HCl2. When exposed to light, silver 1 chloride, that is AgCl, blackens since it decomposes into chlorine. See, it is gets decomposed into chlorine, and silver is forming, metallic silver, which is liberated as a fine black powder. AgNO3 is used as a test for hydrochloric acid and also for chloride ion. Important. So, if the test for chloride ion is asked, you have to write this AgNO3 plus HCl. It is giving you AgCl as a precipitate, white precipitate, which is insoluble in nitric acid and soluble in ammonium hydroxide solution. Okay. Uses of hydrochloric acid. General uses. Hydrochloric acid is used in the laboratory as a common reagent. You all know about it. It is used in preparing aqua regia. Okay, that also you know. Industrial uses. Used for manufacturing chlorine and chlorides, dyes, paints, and photographic materials, AgCl. Glucose from starch. Use in the industry for pickling steel. What is that? Clean the steel by removing surface oxides. Next is preparing bone black by dissolving calcium phosphate present in bone. Removing rust from steel sheet and bars. Cleaning metal surface before electroplating, galvanizing, soldering, etc. Extracting glue from bones. Tanning and printing. So you have to learn these uses. Medicinal use of hydrochloric acid. HCl is prescribed to the patients with decreased gastric juice. HCl helps in digesting proteins and destroying microorganisms that enter stomach through food. Analytical test for hydrogen chloride and hydrochloric acid. HCl gas possesses a typical characteristic smell, but this is not a chemical test. Next, HCl gas, when comes in contact with ammonia solution or ammonium hydroxide solution, it produces thick white fumes of ammonium chloride. NH3 plus HCl, it is giving you NH4Cl. This is a test for HCl. If you dip a glass rod in ammonia solution and just bring it near the mouth of the test tube where HCl is taken, then it will give you a dense white fumes of NH4Cl. Both HCl gas and acid precipitate out as white silver chloride solution from silver nitrate solution. I already told you this, AgNO3 plus HCl, it will give you white precipitate of AgCl. Now this precipitate is insoluble in nitric acid but soluble in ammonium hydroxide. This is the important test for HCl or chloride ion. Chlorine, a greenish yellow gas, is liberated when HCl is heated with oxidizing agent MnO2. This is also a very important reaction. MnO2 plus HCl, MnCl2 plus Cl, H2O plus Cl2. The liberated gas turns moist starch iodide paper blue black. Okay? So these are the tests for hydrogen chloride or hydrochloric acid. Now this is the end of lecture 2 on HCl. So we have completed the whole HCl chapter. Please go through the videos. Practice all the reactions. Write all the reactions and practice. This chapter, so many reactions are there and the reactions are important.